Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And if you have been watching our channel, especially these workshop videos, you have maybe noticed that our workshop isn't always like the most organized and the cleanest workshop. But now, Timo has been cleaning a lot with our mill operator. And they have truly made some like progress. And the workshop is looking already much better.
Yeah.
Especially the like bandsaw area is now really cool, and the saw is also much better. And while we are cleaning, we found a lot of like old stuff that has been like sitting on its place many years, and there is a lot of like really interesting machines and stuff that we found. And now top 5 workshop treasures.
Treasure hunting!
Yeah, so let's start. Yep, so here we have 2 first things. I think this is the best thing first. I'm like most hyped up about this. We have 3 giant pneumatic cranes. And let's see if we have right pneumatic connection size on some of these. And let's try how they work. Yeah, this is pretty large. It's says Profi, made in Germany. Yeah, let's hook up the iron, see if it works. Yep, so the iron goes here.
What?
And then you should attach string here and here. And then you have 2 strings. And from 1 string, it goes up.
Wow!
And from another one, it goes down.
Oh my, this is too cool.
And this can lift more than that.
Wow.
There. So it's like...
Do it again.
It's quite slow, but it has to be because it has so high lift capacity. Yeah, but it works.
Really cool.
And this one is 6 tons. And this one is Atlas Copco and it's 1 ton. And then we have 3rd one. And this is the smallest.
It's small.
This is also Atlas Copco and it's 400 kilos. But this is pretty handy if you have to like lift something somewhere and you don't have like 3-phase power. With this 6-ton thing, you just need like regular air compressor and you have huge lifting capacity. Yeah, so pretty good first one. I give 5 out of 5. Yep, and here is the first found. We have 2 extra 4-jaw chucks to pick lathe. And I think these were cheap like 15 years ago when Timo bought them. And now they are for sale.
Tää on Georgia Pacificin paperitehtaalta. Georgia Pacific.
Yeah, they are from like paper paper
mill. Georgia Pacific in Tokyo.
Yeah. So if you need like really good and not hardly used at all lathe chucks, here is your chance.
Please leave a comment.
We are not going to ship them to States. It would be probably cost more than the chucks.
Tää on varmaan made in Sweden.
Swedish chuck. There is some markings.
Vai mitä tuossa lukee?
Made by.
Tää on varmaan, tääkin on amerikkalainen.
Cushman chuck.
Niin.
Yeah, it's hardly used at all. Looks really good.
Mulla on tarvetta näitä.
it's really warm here.
Yeah, we have new heat pump. It's like air to air, and I have video about that coming. It's really good machine. And then the next one, I think this is going to be even better. This should be like really nice. Yeah, it's a bit bigger and it has adjustable jaws. So you can like micro adjust here and you can also flip this. It doesn't say where it's made, but these work that you have the two bolts here. So you open them and you can move this wherever you want. And then you can screw from here or here and this moves. So it's fast to make bigger movements than by like spinning this all the way from here to here. But it doesn't say where it's made. But it's pretty nice still. How many points you want to give?
9.
9. 9 out of chuck. Yep, and this is an old analog panel from a balancing machine. And we have modernized the frame of the machine. It's now controlled with laptop and like electronics. So we don't need this anymore, but it's just so like, I'm not sure, I think it's even like beautiful. And it's, I think it looks like some kind of radar thing from like 50s or something. And you can like turn everything of these. So I think we are not going to throw it away or press it. It's like too technical and too looming. If I ever have kids, I'm going to put this on my like playing corner and the kid can like turn everything of these and like pretend to be something. Yeah, but really good.
Look what I found. This is a bit outdated.
And then the next treasure, dust covers for old Ford Mondeo. No, it's not this. Pretty large wheel. Yeah, this is not like a super useful machine. We have better version of this also, but I think this is like, it's somehow really pleasing machine.
Yeah, nice to have.
So this is magnetic table for milling machine. And it works like this, that you have something that you want to mill. I get something. So we would like to mill this surface totally flat in one go. But this is so thin that it's hard to mount. But if I put it here and then pull from this lever, It's stuck now there.
Magic.
And now you can mill it. Yep, and when the work is ready, just turn this again and you can take it away. This isn't super strong. I think it's from like grinding machine or finishing machine, not like milling machine. So it's not super strong. But I have also electric ones of the same concept. And those are actually really cool and I have used them many times. But I think this is like, it's so just simple and easy to use that it's like really pleasing. Yeah, it stays there quite hard, but not super hard. The electric one is much better. And then the next one, this is like, I'm not sure if it's like technical term, but this is like a spark cutting machine. And here is the like unit. And it's a bit of mess. We have never used this, but I think it has all the parts. So it uses electricity. And here is the like head. The idea is to install this to milling machine. Here is the head and to here. You get electricity and cutting fluid from this. And then you mount this here. I think it's missing like part between of these two. But the idea is that when you broke, for example, like thread, tap, or some drill, and it gets stuck inside of your piece that you are working, And the drill is really hard material, and it's really hard to drill out the drill, because what you are going to do, drill with the drill, it's not going to work like that. But with this, you hook this up and you start to shove this really slowly inside of the drill, and there is going to be a lot of tiny sparks on end of this, and the sparks are going to break the material of the drill, and then the cutting fluid that comes out here pushes the like drill sheet out from the hole, and you can eat up the drill from the hole where it's stuck with this. So really handy machine if you like have, sometimes it's like huge problem if you have really expensive and big piece that you are working, and then your tool breaks and it gets stuck inside and you have to get it out with somehow. And this is like good like last resort. This works every time. And I think these are pretty expensive. And it would be probably nice to get this running. It's quite complicated machine, as you can see. Yeah, but I didn't even remember that we have this, but it's here.
It's workshop treasure.
Yeah, and this box is for the cutting fluid.
Disgusting.
And these are always nasty. How much you give points to this?
2 out of 3.
I think the like pneumatic crane is on the lead.
Yeah.
It was even better than the lathe chucks. Yep, there was 5.
Yeah.
Which was your favorite?
The hypnotizing machine.
I have to go with the pneumatic crane.
Especially, really cool.
Especially the big one is like really nice thing to have. You don't need those very often, but some things that you just want to have.
Yeah.
In case, just in case. And there is also a bit similar video than this on Anni's channel. What's that about?
Auction treasures.
Yeah, we have been going like auctions, and we have buying stuff for our company, and also just like decorative stuff for our house. And you have, did you make also top 5?
Yeah, this is top 5 week.
Top 5 week. Yeah. So link to that is in description and end screen. Go check that out and subscribe and Anni's channel. Yeah. But that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.